We've now taken a look at how inserting records plays with foreign keys. So now we're going to take a look at the exact opposite operation. What happens when you try to delete some record that involves a foreign key? So here's the situation I want to take a look at. Right now, inside of our database, we've got that photos table and the users table. Inside of photos, there are three different photos, these right here, that are all associated with a user that has ID number 1. So here's the question. What would happen if we deleted the user with ID number 1? So if we just dropped away user Monahan. If that happened, we would then have some dangling keys right here, some dangling references. In other words, these photos are now trying to reference a user that does not exist and never will exist. Remember, our IDs are making use of that serial data type. Whenever we use that serial data type, no ID ever gets reused, even if a record with some given ID gets deleted. So when we delete the user with ID number 1, there will never ever be another user with ID number 1. And so these photos right here are never going to be referencing any user again. So we would have to add in some code inside of our database or our application to somehow detect that we've got some photos here that aren't referencing any user that exists. And that would be kind of annoying and not the best thing in the world. So when we make use of foreign keys, we can specify some options for exactly what we want to have happen whenever we try to delete a record that some other rows are dependent upon. In this case, we would say that these three photos are dependent upon that user with ID number 1. We have a couple of different options we can use. In this table, we're seeing the five different options or the five different things we can do whenever we try to delete that dependent record. By default, the option that gets used if we don't specify anything at all is onDeleteRestrict. That means that if we try to delete a user when a photo is still referencing it, we're going to end up getting an error message. And we can test this very easily. Back over here, I'm going to write out a statement to try to delete the user with ID number 1. So I'll say delete from users where ID equals 1. That would result in three dangling photos. If I try to run that, I then get a nice big error message. So this is a foreign key constraint around deletion that is preventing us from deleting that user. Let's take a look at some other options we have available, and then we'll try to play around with these. And by the way, I know that right now it's not clear where we would use these options. I'll show you where in just a moment. So again, the default behavior is onDeleteRestrict. There is another option called onDeleteNoAction that will also throw it an error. There is technically a difference between what restrict and no action does. We'll discuss what that difference is later. It's a very small difference that has absolutely no impact at where we are right now. Some of the other things we can do is something called a cascade delete. So if we do an onDelete cascade, that means that whenever we delete a user, we are also going to delete all the photos that reference it as well. So in other words, if we delete the user with ID number 1, our database would go into the photos table, it would find all the different photos that are referencing the user with ID 1 and delete those photos as well. OnDelete Cascade is frequently a really good option if we want to try to delete a user and all the data associated with them. Some other options we have are set null. So in this case, if we delete a user, we're going to find all the photos associated with that user and set the user ID of them to null. So in that scenario, we can imagine we would delete user with ID 1, and then we would go to null, null, and null. So these photos will still exist, but there is a clear sign here that says there is no user associated with them. And then finally, we can use an onDeleteSetDefault. So we have not discussed this yet, but when we create a table, we can specify that a column should have a default value associated with it. So when you and I insert data into that table, if we do not provide a value for a column, there will be instead some kind of default value that gets used. If we do that, and we set this option right here, then if we ever delete the associated user, the user ID column of the photo will be assigned some kind of default value. We'll see an example of that later on as well. Okay, so that's what all these different options do. But now your inevitable question is, where do we set these options? Well, that's the big question. Let's take a big pause right here. When we come back next video, we're going to figure out how to set these options, and we'll do some testing with cascade and null.